The craziest things have happened recently, guys. LOONA Chuu is under attack because of what she said on her show. On the other hand, the former member of Wonder Girls, Yeun, was appointed by the Ministry of Justice and received a backlash. Several music producers called out HYBE for not paying them. Let's not waste any more time and get right into all the juicy stuff. I'm gonna start with our boy JB from GOT7. On July 24th, a YouTube channel, Esquire, published a video with JB titled JB Reacts to Videos of Himself. The video was super hilarious since JB reacted to some embarrassing moments from his past, but also to some things that he cherished and considered to be precious memories. He first reacted to a song with Jin Young from the unit JJ Project, under which they released together a single Bounce, before GOT7 debuted. JB revealed that he doesn't like this song at all, and it really wasn't his style. He said, "I just can't stand it a bit," and continued by saying that he would never do something like that again. He really had a lot to say about a clip of him dancing in a skirt during one of GOT7's concerts. JB got super embarrassed and revealed that he had to do it. He continued by saying that these things used to happen in K-pop in the past. JB stated, "It was something that was possible only back then. Service to the fans, should I call it." And he's absolutely right. Back in the day, male K-pop idols often dressed as females and danced or performed some very questionable things. However, as the world is progressing, these things are now usually considered rude and many entertainment agencies are trying to avoid doing them. Anyway, I absolutely love JB and I think this video of him reacting to his old stuff is simply hilarious. Hilarious or not, the same cannot be said about what happened to Aping's Eunji. She decided to put a stop to the cruel saucing behavior once and for all. Eunji really said, enough is enough. She jumped on Twitter and wrote, "There are people who come to my house these days. I really dislike it myself too, but the thing is, it is also inconvenient and causes trouble for those around me too." She didn't end the post there though. Eunji showed that she isn't scared to fight against these saucings and continued with saying, "People who only care about their own feelings seem like they will not be able to respect me either. Let us please love in a healthy way." After this, Eunji revealed that there are pictures of her dog circulating the internet and that she has never taken these photos, which only means that someone must have gone near her house and taken them while she was out. Eunji said that this makes her very angry, and rightfully so. She ended her post like the baddie that she is. "People who read this and feel guilty because it applies to you, please sort yourselves out." Even people who aren't Eunji's fans expressed their support. Some fans need to start respecting idols as humans and stop treating them as objects for them to enjoy. I have no idea what's running through the heads of these saucings, but girl, they are crazy. And now to our girl Chuu from LOONA. I know, we all love LOONA. Their music is simply amazing. I mean, I don't know about you, but girl, I have Paint the Town on repeat ever since it came out. There's no way to stop me from listening to it, okay? It's a bop, period. But we have some major drama to discuss. On July 22nd, an episode of Chuu Can Do It aired, and it struck quite the controversy. Chuu was supposed to complete a mission in which she had to go into the streets and find someone who is subscribed to her YouTube channel. At one point, she came across a student who was busy preparing for his master's. The boy admitted to being a fan and said this, "I always see you with high energy even in the morning when everyone is without much energy. I feel like..." Chuu asked him why he feels that way, and he told her that he went home at 10 p.m. yesterday because he was studying. Well, that's when Chuu said something that many people found controversial. Chuu reacted to his words by saying, "I went home at 2 a.m. yesterday after I danced like crazy like this." She continued her statement by revealing that she had to wake up at 6 a.m. that day in order to start filming, and then proceeded to say, "You should be happy that you can have breakfast. You see, I'm on a diet. What can you eat? There's stew here and noodles here. Please be happy." Now, the message of "please be happy" is really beautiful, but many people pointed out that Chuu shouldn't have said the previous things. This situation can be compared to having a conversation with your friend. You tell them that you're struggling with something and you want them to listen. You don't want them to make it seem like your problems don't matter. Chuu most likely didn't have any malicious intentions by speaking this way, but it simply came out wrong, which sometimes happens. Many netizens criticized Chuu way too much. At least that's my opinion. However, fans pointed out that not everything is what it seems. Some say that this was also the fault of editors because they added some extra words on screen that were later taken out of context. I don't think it's right to attack Chuu for saying these things, because I'm pretty sure that she understands what happened and that it came out a little wrong. Mistakes happen, and all we can do is learn from them. So let's give the same opportunity to idols too. The member of now inactive Wonder Girls, Yeun, has been making big headlines lately. Yeun is now known in the entertainment industry as TFELT, and her art, music, and work is absolutely amazing. Yeun has been pretty vocal about her political views and what she believes in on her social media, and she has just been appointed by the Ministry of Justice as a member of the Commission for the Task Force that studies the policies against attacks. You can only imagine that this is a huge success for Yeon and that something like this doesn't happen every day. The task force is led by Seo Ji-hun, who was a huge advocate for the Me Too movement in South Korea. Back in 2018, the Ministry of Justice started to appoint celebrities to help fight against these terrible crimes, but Yeon is the first to be appointed as a member of a committee that proposes policies and systems to deal with the alarming situation in South Korea. In October 2019, Yeon shared a post in which she declared her love for the movie Kim Ji-young, Born 1982, that was based on the same titled novel by Cho Nam-joo. Yeon expressed her support for all the women, and especially those who were born in the 80s and have experienced unfair treatment from the government and South Korean society in general. After she publicly admitted that she was a feminist and supported the movement, she received a big wave of backlash. Now, when she was appointed by the Ministry of Justice, some people decided to attack her online and call her a radical feminist. The disgusting comments and rude remarks left on her account are made especially by South Korean men who perceive feminism as some kind of plague that invaded South Korea in recent years. People reacted to a post by TMI Kpop on Twitter and summed up the situation perfectly. It's crazy how we have an image of Korea so different from reality. In every single country, being a feminist brings you so much trouble. I applaud her, so brave for being a feminist in Korea. I wish everything will go well for her. Many fans of Hotfeld expressed their support for the idol in comments like, "Proud of you, respect," or "I'm proud to say she was my bias in Wonder Girls." And if you wonder what Yeon's reaction to all the hate is, it's very simple. "I have no regrets. Honestly, she deserves all the love and support. I absolutely love her." And last but not least, we gotta talk about HYBE, which has received a lot of heat in recent days. Before we jump into any conclusions, I want to dissect the whole situation and really take you through what happened and how things went down. On July 22nd, a music producer, Goopy Music, posted a tweet in which he claimed the following. "K-pop band TXT pitted a bunch of hyperpop producers against each other without telling any of them, and I'm curious who got chosen to do the beat. I didn't, and spent weeks on it, so I'm leaking the info." To this tweet, producer Kevin Brim reacted by saying that they were asked to write 6 songs for TXT. The producer, Umru, revealed that he thinks they got almost everyone who produces hyperpop music. Some fans proceeded to attack these producers by laughing at them and saying that this is how the industry works, which, if you ask me, is extremely disrespectful to say without any of these fans actually working in the industry. Well, the issue is much bigger than this, and one person explained the situation perfectly. The thing is that the management of HYBE actually reached out to these producers to make music. It wasn't the other way around. It's the same situation as if a painter is asked to paint a portrait of someone, then they obviously expect money for their work. If the situation was that these producers sent their demos and songs to HYBE because they simply wanted to, then of course, they don't have to expect to get paid if they get rejected. One K-pop stan posted a tweet in which they say, "It's beyond me how K-pop stans will listen to music and praise a group for their perfect discography and never once think about the producers behind it. And once it is revealed how the people who work behind the scenes are treated, they will go as far as defend the company." What we can take from this situation is that TXT are not the ones to be attacked, nor the producers. The ones who deserve the backlash is HYBE. They literally tried to use these upcoming music producers who have little to no exposure as a form of free labor and don't pay them for their work. And that's a behavior we will not tolerate. But I want to know what your thoughts on all of these things are, guys. Leave your opinions in the comments. Thank you for watching. Bye!